Hi everyone, and welcome to this video about getting macOS Monterey installed on unsupported hardware. macOS Monterey was released a few days ago, and just as with most new releases of macOS, this one is no exception, and Apple decided to remove official support for some of the older hardware. In general, anything older than a 2015 model is no longer supported on this new release. This doesn't necessarily mean that the hardware of these models cannot handle the new operating system. In most cases, it would run it just fine. Luckily, there are still ways to get around these restrictions and to install macOS Monterey on officially unsupported models. In an earlier video, I described how to install the predecessor of Monterey, Big Sur, on unsupported models as well. For that video, I used MicroPatcher. For this video, I will go for a different method and I will use OpenCore Legacy Patcher to get around the hardware checks instead. In contrast to MicroPatcher, this method uses an unmodified macOS installer. Instead, it tricks that installer in thinking it is running on a newer but supported model. It should be possible to use this method on most of the Macs starting from around 2008, although some of these will really start to struggle to bring you a fluent and snappy experience with macOS. On the website of OpenCore Legacy Patcher, you can find a comprehensive list of models on which OpenCore is supported. For this video, I'll be using a late 2013 iMac with model identifier iMac 14.2. My model has the highest spec CPU, an i7-4771, a 256GB SSD, 16GB of RAM, and the NVIDIA GeForce GTX 780M. This video card makes it interesting, as support for NVIDIA GPUs has been really trimmed down a lot in Monterey. The iMac is running macOS Catalina as a starting point, which is the last officially supported release on this model. Before we get started, I'd also like to mention that I have a blog, yenzi.be, where you can find all the steps that I will follow in this video in detail. So if you plan to go through this yourself, you can find all details you need over there. Now to get started, the first thing that we need is to get our hands on the installer for Monterey. As the device which you want to get Monterey on is officially not supported, the installer will not be shown in the App Store on this device. So we need to find another way to get our hands on the installation package for Monterey. Mr. Macintosh keeps a list with versions and links to directly download the file we need. At the time I created this video, the latest and actually only release version was 12.0.1, as you can see here. Let's download that package. Once the download completes, we can double-click on it and run through the dialog to install macOS Monterey to your application folder. In case you would encounter issues due to any hardware checks in this package, which I did not experience on my iMac by the way, you can also manually extract the .app from the .pkg and move the app to your applications folder. You can use the following commands in terminal for that. Which of these both methods you use doesn't really matter, as long as you end up with the install macOS Monterey application in your applications folder. This is what we need for the next step. In case you would be curious and try to run this directly on an unsupported model like mine, as you can see, this won't work as you will get the following error message. Now that we have the installer downloaded and ready, we will use it to create a bootable Monterey installation USB. First, we need to prepare the USB drive to make sure we can boot from it and patch it later with OpenCore in the next steps. To do so, insert the USB drive and open Disk Utility. In Disk Utility, click to show all devices. Then, in the left column, select your USB drive and click Erase on the top menu. Give the drive a name. I chose 32G USB. Select macOS Extended and GUID as Scheme and click Erase. When this is done, we can use the installer to prepare the USB drive and get files on it. To do so, open a new terminal window and execute the following command. And then enter your user's password when asked. In case you called your drive different when erasing it with Disk Utility, you will need to adapt this in the command here. This can take quite some time, depending mainly on the speed of your USB drive. Alright, that is done and we can exit the terminal. At this point, we have a standard bootable USB drive for installing Monterey. This one could be used to install Monterey on supported hardware. But that's not what we're trying to do here, so let's move on and build and install OpenCore to the USB drive instead. OpenCore is a bootloader and it's often used for Hackintosh builds, but it runs on real Apple hardware just fine as well. OpenCore patches or changes some data in memory, making the software think it's running on newer hardware, and this bypasses the restrictions on the installer. To start with this, we first need to download the latest version of the patcher from GitHub. As you can see, there is a graphical version, an offline text-based version, and a regular text-based version. This is the one we need. After downloading the file, we can just open it from our downloads. This brings up a new terminal window with several options. We need to start here with option 1, and that is to build OpenCore. This shouldn't take very long, and as you can see in the output, this has built OpenCore specifically for the Mac model which we are working on, iMac 14.2 in my case. Press Enter to go back to the main menu, and now choose option 2, Install OpenCore. In this option, select your USB drive from the list. Here I have drive 0 as my internal drive, and drive 3 as the USB drive. This is the one we need. In the next screen, we need to select the only EFI partition which exists on that drive. And after entering our password, the OpenCore bootloader will be installed to that EFI partition on the USB drive. In a later stage, we will have to repeat this process, but for the internal drive in our Mac. The USB drive is now fully prepared. Now it's time to boot the Mac from the USB drive in order to install Monterey. To do so, reboot your Mac and hold down the Option key during boot time. Holding down the Option key brings up the bootloader, and in here you should see the currently installed system first, named Catalina in my case, an entry to install Monterey, and an EFI boot entry with the OpenCore logo. The last two are coming from our USB drive. From here, which is a standard bootloader, we can't start the installation as we need to do this from OpenCore to hide the real system identifier. Instead, select the EFI boot entry using the arrow keys and press Enter. This brings you in OpenCore. As you can see, this looks very similar to the standard bootloader. The only difference is the text at the right bottom corner. Apologies, by the way, for the poorly readable graphics and text. Somehow I always find it hard to film the super reflective and bright screen which is in these iMacs. From here, we can choose the Install macOS Monterey option. This launches the installer from the USB drive, which can take some time. Eventually, macOS Recovery comes up, from which we can do the installation. At this point, we need to decide where we will install Monterey. There are basically three options. Option 1 is a fresh install, where we will remove the existing installed system and give the full drive to Monterey. Option 2 is a dual boot, where we will add a new volume and resize the existing one to keep your current macOS and add Monterey to it. Or option 3, upgrade, where we will upgrade the existing installed system. For the last one, there is no need to go to Disk Utility and to do any preparation. For the first two, on the other hand, there is a need to launch Disk Utility first from the menu. We need to do this to prepare our drive. In Disk Utility, first click on the button to show all devices. For option 2, Dual Boot, where we will add Monterey together with our currently installed macOS, click your internal drive on the left side and click Partition. Here, click on the plus sign to add a partition and choose to add a partition rather than a volume. You can change the size on the left side, name the volume, and choose APFS as format. I just wanted to show this to you because that's not what I will do for this video. Instead, I will go for option 1, where I will completely replace Catalina, which is installed at the moment, with Monterey. For this, click your internal drive on the left side and click Erase instead. Give the drive a name, I chose Monterey, choose APFS as format and GUID as scheme. As soon as Disk Utility is ready with the operations, independent of which option you go for, we are good to move to the next step. Let's get that new version of macOS installed finally. Click Continue here, accept the license agreement, and here we need to select the volume on which you want to install Monterey. So, depending on which option you decided to take, you need to select where to install it. For an upgrade, you need to select the volume which you want to upgrade, which would have been Catalina in my case. For a fresh install or dual boot, that would be the volume which we just created in disk utility and called Monterey. From here on, you can relax and sit back as the installation can take quite some time. If all goes well, you should see the following screen after a series of reboots and a few coffees. This will differ a bit depending if you went for a fresh install or an upgrade. You can notice in some cases that everything is pretty slow here. This is due to the lack of video card drivers or metal support, which we'll take care of in a bit. If all went well, you should end up on the desktop of your newly installed macOS Monterey system. At this point, I was still not able to do any screen recording due to the problem mentioned with the video card drivers, so it'll have to do with the video footage instead. So far, we have successfully installed Monterey on our Mac, but to start it, we still need to boot from the USB drive, as that is where OpenCore is currently installed. In order to get this fixed, we need to install OpenCore to the internal HD or SSD instead. This goes in exactly the same way as we did before for the USB drive. So let's download the latest version of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher again. And let's start it. In the terminal window, we again need to start with option 1, build OpenCore. And again, as we did previously, now choose option 2, install OpenCore. Here we now need to select our internal drive, 0 in my case, instead of the USB drive. In the next step, we need to select the EFI partition again on the drive. And just as we did before on the USB drive, this will install the OpenCore bootloader to the EFI partition, allowing the official bootloader to boot from it and to start macOS Monterey. In case you have a fully supported graphical card, you should be done here, and you can do a reboot to test if everything still works without the USB drive plugged in. If on the other hand, the model of Mac which you are using doesn't have a metal supported card, or you have one of the Nvidia-based models where Apple decided to remove support for, which I have, you need to go through this additional step. To do so, in the OpenCore Legacy Patcher, choose option 3, Post-Install Volume Patch. As you can see in the explanation, this option is to patch your installation for various known problems related to hardware. The patch I need is for support for the Nvidia 700 series graphics. To continue, let me choose option 1 to patch the system volume. Depending on which patch is needed on your system, a selection will be made as you can see. We can confirm here. Enter the password if needed. Confirm the rebuild. And snapshotting. After going through this, all that is left is to perform a reboot to activate the changes we did. Let me quit the patcher. And eject the USB drive. And remove it from the system. Now we are ready to do a reboot. As you can see, the system now boots OpenCore from the internal drive instead and is able to start Monterey from there. In some cases, it might be needed to boot holding the Option key, then select OpenCore for the first time. That should be it. As you can see, graphical performance is fine again and I'm able to record the screen without a terrible slowdown. In case you're curious if there is any performance impact after upgrading to Monterey, after all this is not supported by Apple, I did a Geekbench 5 test on my system before installing Monterey. These were the results for my iMac while being on the latest supported OS, Catalina. And the same test after upgrading to Monterey. Strange to see that the single core score is lower, but the important one, multi-core, is slightly higher, so definitely not worse. In general, the system feels very snappy and I don't really notice any performance loss in comparison with Catalina. Hopefully this video can help you to extend the life of your beloved Apple Mac. Thanks a lot for watching. If you liked this video, please put a thumbs up. If you like this kind of content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel for more of the same. Thanks again and hope to see you back here soon.